Hey all, and welcome back. I'm Gary. Thank you all to the subscribers approaching 400. I can't be more thankful. Really appreciate it. Thank you. Today, we're going to look at Fedora. Fedora 36, in fact. Going to move away from BSDs just for today. Just to see what the competition has to offer. I've heard some good things about it. I've heard that it's using the latest Gnome version of 42. Let's have a look and see what it's like, shall we? So I've got it running on my Mac Mini. It's really crummy hardware. It's running on a mechanical hard drive. I will probably install it onto this at some point just to see if we can squeeze some more performance out of it. I don't know. It depends. We'll see how it goes. So let's have a quick look at what we've got. So here it is. Here's the shell. Let's have a look at what's installed. So I've installed a few applications on it already just to have a quick nose around. So let's have a quick look at this. We got fish on there. Yeah, we have. Look at that. Great. Brilliant. So let's get rid of that. We don't need that. I'm not the hugest fan of Gnome, I'll be honest. It just feels very convoluted and clunky. But in all honesty, this version seems a bit better. But we'll have a look. So I've installed some of the stuff that I would probably use in my day-to-day working. So we've got Audacity. Let's check that out. Is it going to launch? Is it? Yes, it is. So there we go. Audacity is running, I believe, 302. So that's the latest stable, I believe. Big thing for me was to install Chrome. And here it is. I wish they would release this for FreeBSD. It would make things so much easier. Let's have a look. I wonder what version this is, because obviously version 100 just came out. What version is this? 100. Look at that. That's cool. That's really good. Apologies for the dodgy audio. For some reason, audio through HDMI is just not capturing very well, but you know, so be it. So there we go. Chrome working well. Chrome working fairly well. I get the feeling that this hardware has only got a 100 meg NIC in it as well, so that would make it quite slow. Actually, let's have a quick look, see what hardware we've got in this, because it is, like I said, it's quite crummy. Yeah, look at that. See, as I thought. So we've got a Core 2 Duo at 2.4 gigahertz. Although it has got NVIDIA graphics, GeForce 320M. So that kind of explains why I wasn't getting it to work very well on other operating systems. There was me thinking it was in Intel, but it's not. But yeah, so like I said, crummy hardware. Where was we? So let's have a quick look at the other bits. OBS Studio. I would need this for my day-to-day stuff. So there we go. That's good. So OBS Studio. So we've got Libra Office. Let's have a look at that. Yeah, there we go. Libra Office. Hello, world. Yeah, nice. Nah, don't save that. Don't save that. Now, DaVinci Resolve. So I could get away with dumping all the Adobe stuff and using DaVinci Resolve if it runs. Is it going to run? I would suspect not on this hardware. It's probably just going to go, which is what it's done. Look at that. It's just gone away. Okay, fine. I suspect that wouldn't happen if I was to run it on decent hardware. I might actually try installing this on an SSD in my main PC and see what we get. Rhythmbox. So there we go. There's the main bits that I would probably get away with using. Yeah. I wonder if there's VLC. Yeah, of course there is. We'll install that. Just trying to think of what else we could actually install on here. Okay, go away then. We don't want to worry too much about that. I wonder if I could install Caden Live. Maybe I can. I certainly don't think that Caden Live at this point could replace what I'm used to using. Maybe it could. Just not for me at the moment. So yeah, there we go. That's Fedora. I don't like this background, and I don't like that there's no dark mode. So let's have a look-see and see what we got, shall we? That's interesting. Nightlight. There we go. That's better. I quite like that. That's a bit better, isn't it? So let's have a look now. Much better. Much better. Yep. Notifications. Yep. So. That's pretty much all I need to have a look at. We'll maybe revisit this at a later date on real hardware. We'll have to see how that goes. I mean, let me know in the comments, guys, down below, what you think of this. Is it something that you would use, or would you prefer to stick with FreeBSD? I would personally rather stick with FreeBSD, but I could see myself using this. It's not bad. If I can get DaVinci to work, then maybe I would use that. Anyway, leave comments in the comments below. And don't forget to like and subscribe and click the notification bell, because that tells you when I have released new videos. So take care, guys, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye-bye.